What's good, man? You already know what it is. It's your boy Zo White. It ain't right if it ain't Zo White. I'm coming to you back again with another reaction video of the mailman, baby. We are talking about Mr. Karl Malone. He is the, I believe, the second highest points. Let me show you. Karl Malone, John Stockton, y'all boys inspired me to want to play for the Jazz because of them jerseys, them mountain jerseys when y'all point against Jordan. Them jerseys right there. Boy. No, man, giving out them elbows, man. Shit, everybody, damn, they falling like they getting. They falling like they getting knocked the fuck out. He always ran with that punch. Karl Malone isn't talked about enough to have the second most total points in the career. That's for real. We need to do a documentary on the Stockton Malone duo, like that duo. Because it's just like, for Malone to have the second highest total career points of the NBA and not be tall as Kareem, he had to be a beast. He had to always have the ball in his hands. He had to always be shooting. He had to always be shooting at a high percentage to make as many as he could before he left the league. So, how many, like, what, like... I'm not going front. I was, like, sleeping on Malone. Not sleeping on Malone, but... I didn't always talk about Karl Malone, but... This video alone made me think more. He slept. This dude is not, like, he official, man. Imagine how many times Gary Payton and John Stockton had to dish this man the ball. Oh. Wow, that was a powerful video. And it seems like every time a player leaves the NBA, they're relieved. You know, when Jordan left, he was really relieved. He wasn't really sad about it so much. He was more so, you know, relieved and ready to relax. So I got that same vibe with Malone's speech just now. But other than that, man, it's your boy Zo White. It ain't right if it ain't Zo White. Couldn't have it any other way. Peace.